Hi there, my name is Marina Miletic. Heat duty is the amount of energy the heat exchanger must transfer to the process fluid per unit time in order to cool or heat the process fluid to the desired temperature. Heat duty is the combination of the energy needed to cool or heat the process stream from some initial temperature to a final desired temperature, plus the energy required to change the phase of the liquid or vapor if necessary. This first term is typically referred to as simple heat and is described by this formula. An example of simple heat transfer is a hot cup of coffee dissipating heat until it cools down to room temperature. No phase change occurred, only a simple temperature decrease. The second term is typically referred to as latent heat and is described by this formula. An example of this is taking a liquid already at its boiling or bubble point and adding energy to it until it completely vaporizes. Let's look at each of the terms in these equations. In the simple heat formula, m dot is the flow rate of the process stream. C sub p is the average overall heat capacity of the process stream, assuming no phase change. And delta T is the final temperature minus the initial temperature. For the latent heat formula, m dot is the flow rate of the process stream, and lambda is the heat of vaporization or heat of condensation for that process stream. This lambda term refers to the energy required per mass or per mole to change the phase of the process fluid. Let's look at an example of how you would apply each of these formulas to calculate heat duty. Suppose you want to design a heat exchanger which can take water and heat it from 25 to 140 degrees centigrade, assuming it's at 30 psi and flowing at 1 gallon per minute. I chose 1 gallon per minute because it's around the maximum flow rate coming out of most bathroom sink faucets, so this is not a very high flow rate stream. I chose 30 psi because this is around the pressure of water flowing through a typical faucet. The first thing that might stand out to you is that this is a fairly large temperature increase, and this stream will be going from a saturated liquid to a superheated vapor, which means it will be undergoing a phase change. To check this, it's important to look up the boiling point of water at 30 psi. Almost all liquids under high pressure will boil at a higher temperature, so it shouldn't be a surprise that the boiling point is not 100 degrees centigrade, but it's around 120 according to the steam table. What this means is that we'll need to calculate the heat duty in three parts. There's a simple heat temperature increase where liquid water will be heated from 25 to 120 degrees centigrade. Then there will be no temperature increase, but instead vaporization, followed by another simple heat temperature increase from 120 to 140 degrees centigrade. The temperature increase from 25 to 120 is described by this simple heat term. The vaporization is described by this term. And the increase from 120 to 140 is described by this simple heat term. Let's look at each of these terms more closely. M dot is the flow rate of the process stream, the stream we're trying to heat up or cool down, and so its flow rate is 1 gallon per minute. C sub P is the heat capacity of liquid water, which varies a bit from 25 to 120 degrees centigrade, but I averaged it as 4.2 kilojoules per kilogram degree Kelvin. 120 minus 25 is the final minus the initial temperature before the phase change. The latent heat term has an m dot, which again is the flow rate of the process stream, 1 gallon per minute, which is multiplied times lambda, which is the latent heat of vaporization of water at 30 psi. If you look this up on the steam table, this value is about 2200 kilojoules per kilogram, which is a lot of energy. The last simple heat term has an m dot, which is 1 gallon per minute, times the heat capacity of superheated steam, which I averaged between 120 and 140 degrees as around 2.1 kilojoules per kilogram degree Kelvin, times 140 minus 120 degrees centigrade, which is the final simple heat temperature increase. After all these values have been combined, we're left with a final answer of 166 kilojoules per second. This means that our heat exchanger requires 166 kilojoules per second of energy to heat up 1 gallon per minute of water from room temperature to 140 degrees centigrade. This is actually a lot of energy per second, so it's important to understand why this number is so large. Only around 2% of this 166 kilojoules per second is used to heat up the stream from 120 to 140 degrees centigrade. Around 15% of the total heat duty is used to heat up the stream from 25 to 120 degrees centigrade. While an overwhelming 83% is used to not even heat up the stream at all, but to just change its phase from liquid to vapor. So the take-home message here is that whenever a phase change occurs, there's a substantial amount of heat required or released. So if you see a heat duty that appears to be quite large, it's most likely because a phase change is occurring. And one last point about this heat duty, just so we can better understand the magnitude of 166 kilojoules per second, let's put this value in terms of work. This heat duty is the equivalent of raising 4 Toyota Priuses 10 feet in the air every second, a significant amount of work. Thinking about it in terms of a power requirement, 166 kilojoules per second is equivalent to running 45 outdoor air conditioner units at the same time. So it's easy to see that heating and vaporizing even a low flow rate stream like this one that might be coming out of your bathroom faucet requires a tremendous amount of energy every second. Thanks for watching.